Welcome to Microbial Concepts. Today we are going to learn about transgenic animals and plants. Before starting this video, let me remind you to subscribe my channel and please hit the bell icon. Okay, so this topic is related to the genetic modification of these organisms, means plants and animals, and developing a modified version of that plant or animal is nothing but a transgenic version. Okay, so this video we are going to learn about this transgenic animals and plants. So these are some contents we will be looking: definition, introduction, methods, examples, uses and advantages and disadvantages of this transgenic animals and plants. So let's start. So the first we will be learning is transgene. So what is this transgene? It is a foreign gene or genetic material that has been transferred naturally or by any of a number of genetic engineering techniques from one organism to another. Okay, so this is the gene which is used to develop a modified version of an organism. That gene is known as a transgene, which will be transferred from one organism to another by any means maybe naturally or by using any number of genetic engineering technique. Okay, then second term is transgenesis, the phenomenon of introduction of exogenous DNA into the genome or a genome to create and maintain a stable and heritable character. This is known as transgenesis. Okay, then the next term is transgenic plants or animals. Okay, so the plant or animal whose genome is altered by adding one or more transgenes are known as transgenic plants and animals. Okay, so these terms are very important and we will be using these terms in our further video. So we had studied the definitions. Now introduction to our topic. A transgenic animal or plant is one that carries the foreign gene into its genome. Okay, the foreign genes are inserted into the germ line of the animal so that it can be transmitted to its progeny. Okay, so this is done in embryonic stage. Okay, so that the expression of the gene can be studied further and it can be transferred to its progeny, means its offspring. In 1974, Rudolf Janisch created a transgenic mouse by introducing foreign DNA into its embryo. Okay, so that was the first time when a transgenic mouse was created, introducing a foreign DNA into its embryo. Okay, it took another 8 years to pass the transgene to their offspring. Okay, so next 8 years were passed to have an experiment successful where a transgene is further carried over to its offspring. Okay, a super mouse was created by these scientists in 1982. Okay, so Ralph Brinster and Richard Parmeter, they carried out an experiment in which a transgenic mouse was created, and then they studied the transfer or further carry out of the transgenic gene to their offsprings, and they were successful in their experiment. This super mouse was created by inserting a human growth hormone gene in mouse genome. The offspring was larger than parent. So the offspring which came out from this super mouse, that was actually larger than the parent. Okay, so the size of that offspring was larger than that of its parent mouse. Okay, now we will see some points that why transgenic plants or why transgenic animals? What is the need of creating such transgenic plants and animals? Okay, so in case of plants, the transgenic plant may, or we can create transgenic plants which are biotic stress tolerant, which are insecticide resistant, herbicide resistant, or the transgenic plants, they can be developed such that the nutritional quality is improved. These plants can be used in pharmaceuticals and vaccine production, in industrial products, enhance shelf life, and biotic stress tolerance, or biotic stress tolerance. Okay, so these are some points that we can study, or we can use the transgenic plants in these all ways. Okay, in case of animals, these animals can serve as model organisms. They are useful in clinical studies, in vaccine production. They can be developed such that they are resistant to disease. Even in case of transgenic animals, for example, cow or goat, the improved nutrition values can be obtained. Even they can be used in production of antibodies and recombinant proteins. So as we had seen the importance of why do we need these transgenic plants and animals, now we will be studying the methods used to create such transgenic animals. Okay, so first we will be learning about methods used for transgenic animals, and then we will learn about methods used for transgenic plants, producing transgenic plants. So the first step is construction of a transgene. Okay, to carry out transgenic experiment, you need a transgene that you want to use in your experiment. So first is construction of a particular transgene. So a transgene is made up of three parts. First is a promoter, second is a gene to be expressed. Okay, so this is the main part. Gene that you want to study, that is the main part of this transgene. And third is termination sequence. So here I think it is clear enough. Okay, so after having a transgene, next is introduction of this transgene or a foreign gene into a animal. Okay, so how will you introduce this gene? So there are methods such as pronuclear microinjection method and embryonic stem cell method. So let's see what are those methods. First is microinjection method. Okay, so in this experiment, a female animal is super ovulated and eggs are collected. The eggs are fertilized in vitro conditions. The transgene containing solution is injected into the male pronucleus using a micropipette. Okay, so let me show you the diagram. Okay, so in case of egg, this is a female egg, and you can see in diagram the purple color or the violet color is nothing but a female pronucleus, and the red one or slightly pinkish red is nothing but a male pronucleus. Okay, the black color needle like structure is nothing but an injection which will be used for injecting the DNA or the gene, which is a transgene, into this egg. Okay, and towards the left side, it is nothing but a holding pipette. So this pipette will hold this egg so that it is easy for injecting the DNA, the transgene. Okay, eggs with the transgenes are kept overnight in an incubator to develop to a two cell stage. The eggs are then implanted into the uterus of a pseudo pregnant female.
What does this term means? Pseudo pregnant female is nothing but a female which has been mated with a vasectomized male the previous night. Okay, so these eggs are then implanted to the uterus of a pseudo pregnant female. Okay, now in this female there is a favorable environment present, so this egg will now further proceed to its development. The embryo will form and then a complete transgenic animal is produced, okay, or it gets developed, and then it is given birth, and then we can study the transgenic animal which is produced from this female animal. Okay, next is embryonic stem cell method. Transgenic animals can be created by manipulating embryonic stem cell. Okay, so here we are not going to use the egg from female. Here we are going to create a transgenic animal from a stem cell. Okay, so ES means embryonic stem cells. Okay, so ES cells means embryonic stem cells are obtained from the inner cell mass of a blastocyst. Okay, so here is diagram of blastocyst. What does it consist of? Blastocyst is nothing but a structure which is having a inner cell mass which is known as embryoblast, and then a second layer which is known as trophoblast. Okay, and there is a cavity present which is known as blastocyst. Okay, so next point is transgenes. Transgene is incorporated into the ES cells by microinjection, by a retrovirus, by electroporation. Okay, so these are some methods by which a transgene is introduced into the stem cell. Okay, so microinjection we had seen. Retrovirus is a use of virus to insert the gene or to transfer a gene from one cell to the another. Okay, and by electroporation, so we will be learning about electroporation further. Okay, so next point is transgenic stem cells are grown in vitro and then they are inserted into a blastocyst and implanted into a host uterus to grow normally. Okay, so the procedure is almost same, but here we are using embryonic stem cell, not a full fertilized egg. Okay, now after implanting the blastocyst into a host uterus to grow normally, and now after getting a good environment, it will start developing. The third step now comes is screening for a transgenic positives. Okay, transgenic progenies are screened by PCR to examine the site of incorporation of the gene. Some transgenes may not be expressed integrated into a transcriptionally inactive site. Okay, so screening is important part to know whether the incorporation of our gene, our desired gene, which is a transgene, has got properly or not. Okay, so PCR examination is must. Next step is fourth step, which is further animal breeding is done to obtain maximal expression. Okay, so heterozygous offsprings are mated to form homozygous strains. Okay, so next step is breeding of these animals to study the offspring studies and to get maximum expression of our transgene. But there are some problems in these methods. What are those? Multiple insertions may happen which may give too much proteins. Okay, or there are many insertions of our gene, so when it will get expressed, too much protein may be formed. insertion into an essential gene, which may lead to lethality. Okay, if our transgene or our desired gene has got inserted into a very essential gene of an organism, then the vital role of that gene that gets hampered, and thus it may lead to lethality. Next is insertion into a gene leading to gene silencing. Okay, so if a gene is present which is very active and which is very important, and if the insertion of our gene is, or if our gene gets inserted into that gene, then obviously the parent gene or the main gene of the host will not function properly, or it will get silenced. Okay, so there will be not, the gene will not express properly. Our inserted gene is it is like it is killing the function of that gene. Okay, so this is known as gene silencing. A proper particular gene, when its function or when it gets wrecked, we insert our new gene there, obviously it is not going to function properly as previous one. So this is nothing but a gene silencing. Now we are going to learn about production of transgenic plants. Okay, so there are two types of methods: physical gene transfer and chemical gene transfer. Okay, so in case of physical gene transfer, electroporation is one of the example we will be studying. Electroporation involves the creation of pores in the cell membrane using electric pulse of high field strength. Okay, so when a cell is placed in an electric field, the cell membrane is hampered and it gets permeabilized. Okay, so the pores will form in the cell membrane. I hope it is clear in diagram given below. So the cell wall gets weakened, pores are formed, and in this case now it is easy to transfer our DNA into the desired gene, desired cell. Okay, so when a cell which is having its cell membrane permeabilized, now in this case if our DNA is present in buffer, these cells can easily take up these desired gene or desired DNA present in the buffer, and now it is easy to travel inside the cell. So once the DNA is taken up by our cells, the DNA now gets inside the cell, and now it can easily be incorporated into the gene of parent cell, okay, or the parent DNA, inside the parent DNA. Okay, if DNA is present in buffer solution at sufficient concentration, it will be taken up through these pores. Okay, so that is what I explained. Next is micro injection. We had already studied about micro injection in production of transgenic animals. Third is particle bombardment. Okay, so this is a method which is also known as micro projectile bombardment, bioelastic, and gene gun. Okay, so it is nothing but a foreign DNA coated with a high velocity gold or tungsten particles is delivered to the DNA into is it is used to deliver DNA into cells. This method is widely used because of its ability to transfer foreign DNA into the mammalian cells and microorganisms. Okay, so here is the diagram. I think it is okay. Yeah, so in this diagram you can see there is a gas chamber or a portion where air is pressurized. To that gas chamber there is a plastic bullet to which these gold beads coated with DNA are present. So they are triggered in such a way that they will go to the dish, or they will fall inside the dish which has callus or leaf cells inside. Okay, so this is the way by which particles are bombarded, okay, from one point to the another. So here gold beads which are coated with DNA, they are bombarded from the gas chamber to the dish which has callus present. Okay, so this is done inside a vacuum chamber. Next is chemical gene mediated transfer. Polyethylene glycol mediated transformation. Okay, so this is a method which comes under chemical gene mediated transfer. PEG is nothing but polyethylene glycol. Okay, so polyethylene glycol in the presence of divalent cations destabilizes the plasma membrane of protoplast and renders it permeable to a naked DNA. Okay, so here also plasma membrane is make weakened, or when a plasma membrane gets destabilized in presence of polyethylene glycol and divalent cations, it gets easy for a DNA to cross the plasma membrane and get inside the cell. Okay, a large number of protoplasts may be simultaneously transformed. Okay, so large number of protoplasts can be handled in this method. It has certain limitations, such as the DNA is susceptible for degradation and rearrangement. Okay, so in this method DNA can be degraded, so that is a disadvantage. The random integration of foreign DNA into genome may result in undesirable traits. Regeneration of plants from transformed protoplast is difficult task. Okay, so these are some disadvantages of this method. Next is DEAE, which is dextran mediated transfer. Okay, the desirable DNA can be complexed with a higher molecular weight polymer. That should be polymer, there is a spelling mistake, sorry for that. The desirable DNA can be complexed with a high molecular weight polymer, diethyl amino ethyl, which is DEAE, diethyl amino ethyl dextran, and transferred. Okay, the major limitation of this approach is that it does not yield stable transformers. Okay, so there is a stability issue in this case, or in this method. So now we will study some examples. These are some examples for transgenic plants. Golden rice, which has beta carotene present in it, and after ingestion the beta carotene will be converted to vitamin A. Okay, so this comes under nutritional importance. Okay, so the nutritional value of rice is improved here. Then next is transgenic potato. They are produced as they have high productivity, nutritional quality, and resistance to disease. Okay, so next example is of potato, transgenic potato, which are drought tolerant. Next is insecticide sweet corn. It is modified so that it produces a poison that kills harmful insects, and it is helpful to farmer as well. Next example is long lasting tomatoes. So the transgenic variety of tomatoes is developed so that they remain firm and fresh for longer time. Other examples are purple tomatoes, purple rose, colorful cauliflower, and tearless onions, colorful corns. Now we will study about transgenic animals. First is superfish. It has increased growth and size. Next is glowfish, which has fluorescent protein genes inserted. Next is oncomouse, which is used as a model organism to study cancer, and it has genes which are inserted with activated oncogenes. Okay, so cancer causing genes which are activated, those are inserted in this mouse. Next is pig for organ transplant. They are inserted with human genes to decrease chance of organ rejection by humans. Next is transgenic sheep, which has good quality of wool. Next is transgenic cattle. Production of lactoferrin and interferon in their milk. Okay, so genes are inserted which will induce production of these lactoferrin and interferon in their milk. And more examples are Alzheimer mouse and smart mouse. Bioreactors whose cells have been engineered to synthesize marketable proteins. Okay, so what does a bioreactor means? In case of E. coli or say any other microorganism which has good industrial importance, that is now engineered or it is modified such that it can synthesize a marketable protein. Okay, so this is a transgenesis or transgenic microorganism. So this is example which is included for the use of transgenesis or this technique in case of microorganisms. Next is transgenic rabbit. Transgenic artwork, this rabbit is known for a transgenic artwork which was created in 2000. It is named as Alba and the EGFE. It has enhanced green fluorescent pro bunny. Okay, so it has some green fluorescent genes present, so it will color up as green. Now we will study uses of these transgenic animals. So many transgenic animals are designed to increase the understanding of that now genes contribute to the development of disease such as cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis and Alzheimer. Okay, so these transgenic animals are developed or they are designed to increase the understanding, which means to study these diseases such as cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis and Alzheimer. The transgenic mice are being used in testing the safety of vaccines before they are used in humans. Okay, so for safety concerns or for safety testing, transgenic mice are developed. Increase in quality and quantity of wool, which is more profitable. So this is in case of sheep. Sheep could be made resistant to fly strike by producing chitinase in their skin to kill the larva. Okay, so the point which we had seen before about disease resistance. So this is example of sheep. Next is transgenic pigs with phytase expressed in their saliva efficiently, though, so that they can digest dietary phytate and decrease the phosphate in excretion. Sorry for that. Okay, so I hope now it is visible. Some more examples: making animals disease resistant, improving quality of milk, meat, eggs, etc. can be used for antibody production. They can be used for antibody production and they can be used for cancer studies. Okay, then production of recombinant proteins. Now we will study some uses of plants, transgenic plants. In case of vaccine production, potatoes have been studied using a portion of E. coli enterotoxin in mice and humans, and then transgenic potatoes were produced. Okay, so a portion of E. coli enterotoxin in mice and in humans, and then in transgenic potatoes they were studied, and ingestion of these transgenic potatoes resulted in satisfactory vaccination and no adverse effects. which means that potatoes were studied. A portion of E. coli enterotoxin in mice and in humans that was studied, and a transgenic potato was produced. And ingestion of these transgenic potatoes resulted in satisfactory vaccination and no adverse effect. So edible vaccines are vaccines produced in plants that can be administered directly through ingestion of plant. Okay, so just eating that plant or a part of that plant will help in vaccination. Okay, so this is these plants are known as edible vaccines. Okay, so eating plant would then confer immunity against the disease. Okay, so eating these plants or the part of any of that plant, that would confer immunity against the disease. So other examples are banana, tomato, alfalfa, corn and wheat. Next is example in case of insect resistant plants. Use of Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a Bt toxin against larva of Lepidopteron. We all know about Bt cotton or Bt brinjals. So what does that Bt stands for? It is nothing but a toxin produced by Bacillus thuringiensis organism. Okay, so even Bacillus is known to produce various cry proteins. Cry 1 is known to kill butterflies and moths. Even Cry 2 is known for the same. Cry 3 protein kills beetles and Cry 4 protein kills only flies. Okay, so to get resistance against insects, plant is modified with these genes. Okay, then there is example of golden rice. A transgenic technology produced a type of rice that accumulates beta carotene in rice grains. When it is consumed, beta carotene is converted to vitamin A. So this is example for nutrition, improved nutritional quality. So after studying some examples, now we will be studying about advantages and disadvantages of this transgenic technique. Advantages of these transgenic plants and animals: they may help to create new medicines and treatments for illness. Benefits agriculture and industry by being more profitable. Okay, so this point means being more profitable in case of improving nutritional qualities and quantity. For that you can write example of improved milk quality, improved wool quality and improved growth and size of fish. So this is nothing but it will be more profitable in case of agriculture and industry. Next is construct disease resistant plants and animals. Help to improve nutritional qualities, help in studying action of a particular gene during development or other biological processes. In case of crops, longer shelf life can be obtained, thus less waste. Now let's study some disadvantages. The inserted gene may have multiple functions. So this is a one limitation or disadvantage. Next is breeding problems, then low survival rate. Sometimes transgenesis may lead to mutagenesis and functional disorders. The process is expensive, time consuming and labor intensive. There are ethical issues related as we are using plants and animals. Next is low success rate. Then large number of recipients are required for embryo transfer because of low transgenic rates. Next is safety concerns in case of food. Okay, so these are some disadvantages. I hope this video was useful. Please like, share and comment, and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.